Hello friends, my name is Dr. Puru Dhawan, and in this video we will discuss how baking soda helps a kidney failure patient to slow down the progression of kidney failure disease. Before going towards the baking soda, it's very important for us to understand how kidney works and why we need baking soda. What happens when your kidney suffers from kidney failure disease? The function of the kidney to filter out the waste material goes down. As this function goes down, the waste material like creatinine, urea, potassium starts accumulating in our body. And along with this waste material, there is also one thing which also accumulates in our body, and that is acid. Our body produces lots of acid during metabolism and kidney filters it out. But when the function of the kidney is affected, what happens? Because of this accumulation of acid in the body, the pH of the blood falls. Just to maintain that, we have to give some kind of buffer, and these buffer bicarbonate, sodium bicarbonate, plays very important role, and we know sodium bicarbonate as a baking soda. So all kidney failure who are suffering from kidney failure, they are always advised some kind of bicarbonate so that the bicarbonate level can be easily maintained in the body. For that purpose, doctor usually prescribes some kind of bicarbonate tablet, but it's the same composition of baking soda. Chemically, they are identical, and that is sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3. So if a kidney failure patient wants to slow down the progression of kidney failure disease, this simple compound sodium bicarbonate plays very important role. Because as this acids accumulate in our body, what happens? Because of this acid, our kidney functions affected further. So just to slow down that progression of the disease, we have to use sodium bicarbonate. If the tablet of sodium bicarbonate is not available, person can take 1 spoon of baking powder in a glass of water thrice a day so that the level of the pH can be easily maintained. Now a question arises: this sodium bicarbonate contains sodium, and this sodium is the cause of high blood pressure in anyone. So if a person takes sodium bicarbonate baking soda, will the level of blood pressure will increase? As all nephrologists give this sodium bicarbonate to all patients suffering from kidney failure, none has shown the increased level of blood pressure. So it is very safe for blood pressure, it is very safe for kidney failure patient to take sodium bicarbonate in some amount. Now let's move to kidney failure disease and see how we can manage this kidney failure disease, how we can manage creatinine, urea and potassium with the help of diet, with the help of kidney function restoration treatment. As I told you earlier, when the function of the kidney decreases, what happens? The waste material starts accumulating in the body. We can manage this waste material like creatinine, urea in our body with the help of two ways. First, we can do is that we can decrease the formation of these waste material in the body with the help of diet. If a kidney failure patient, right amount of diet, right kind of diet, what happens? Because of this diet, the production of the waste material decreases in the body. Like if we want to control the level of creatinine in the body, we have to decrease the intake of protein. If a patient takes large amount of protein like pulses, meat, eggs or dairy products like milk, curd, what happens? Because of this high intake of protein, body produces large amount of creatinine, and this creatinine starts accumulating in the body. So all kidney failure patients are advised to take low protein diet or protein free diet. It depends on how the body is. If the body is slim, patient is weak, the protein is advised. If the patient is healthy, energy is high, protein free diet is advised. So it depends how your body is, what is the need of the body. If the body needs protein, we have to give the protein, but the protein should be easily digestible, easily absorbable. So in my practice, I advise all kidney failure patient who need protein to take some kind of protein from moong ki dal or egg white, because these two proteins are easily absorbable. 100% absorbable protein doesn't create any kind of too much amount of creatinine in the body. So if your digestion is good, then you can take 2 egg white or 1 bowl of moong ki dal. There is one more important thing: if you want to control the level of creatinine, you have to avoid all kind of physical exercises like running, swimming and jogging, any kind of vigorous exercise. What happens? Because of this exercise, our muscle metabolism increases. As the muscle metabolism increases, the formation of the creatinine in the muscles also increases, which eventually starts accumulating in your body. So we have to cut down the all kind of vigorous exercise, but some kind of exercise is necessary for all body. So at Science and Jimmy, we advise all kidney failure patient to do some kind of aerobic exercise like anulom vilom, pranayam, kapal bhati. You can also do walk, yoga, because these exercises doesn't produce any kind of fatigue in the muscles, and the level of creatinine can be easily maintained with these kind of exercise. Not only creatinine can be controlled, but when we take large amount of oxygen, what happens? Because of this oxygen, our waste material which is accumulated in the body get oxidized. So it's very important to do some kind of exercise so that not only level of creatinine can be controlled, blood pressure can be easily maintained, and the oxidation of the waste material can also be happen. So do some exercise, but not the bigger exercise. Let's move to the another point. If a patient suffer from fever or shivering or fatigue because of traveling, the level of creatinine increases. So we have to take care of all these things. We have to avoid vigorous exercise, we have to avoid fever, we have to avoid fatigue, we have to avoid shivering, because all these things will create creatinine in your body. Now let's move to the potassium, because potassium is much more fatal than creatinine. Because of potassium, person can have heart attack at any time, because when the level of potassium increases above 7, what happens? Because of this high level of potassium in the body, this potassium produces muscle fatigue, and because your heart is made up of muscles, because of potassium your heart can be stopped. So we have to control the level of potassium, and the potassium comes in the body with the diet. So we have to take care of diet in a such a way, we have to select those food items which contains potassium in a low amount, naturally occurring low amount. So to understand what things contain high amount of potassium and what things contains low amount of potassium, now I will give you a simple formula. With that you can easily understand, you can easily make out what foods are good, what vegetables are good, what cereals are good. So let's move to the vegetable. Vegetable which is grown below the surface of earth, like potato, sweet potato, turnip, is not allowed because they contain large amount of potassium. Exceptions are there: radish, carrot and onion, that can be taken but in a cooked form. Second thing what we have to avoid is the leafy vegetables. Leafy vegetable like mustard, spinach and your coriander, mint, any kind of leafy vegetables contains large amount of potassium, and this will definitely increase your level of potassium. So we have to avoid all leafy vegetables. Now another question arises: if we can't take these vegetables, what we can take? Any vegetable which is grown as a fruit on a plant or a creeper, like brinjal, tomato, bitter ground, round ground, cucumber, can be taken. So when you go into the market, look towards the vegetable and imagine where this vegetable is grown. Is it grown as a tuberous root, or it's grown as a fruit? If a vegetable is a fruit, you can take. If the level of potassium is still high, your level is above 5.5 5.6, you can also leach this vegetable to further lower down the level of potassium. But take care of one thing in mind: if you leach too much of vegetable, what happens? Along with the potassium, lots of vitamins and minerals also goes off. So we have to cut down the leaching as the level of the potassium comes in the control. Now let's move to the fruit section and see what fruits what we can eat. We have to avoid few fruits. First is banana, kiwi, avocado and dates, and all kind of dry fruits, along with citrus fruit. Citrus fruits, because it contains large amount of ascorbic acid and citric acid, which will decrease the pH of the blood. So we have to avoid citric fruits. We have to avoid all fruits like banana, kiwi, avocado, dates and dry fruits, because they contain large amount of potassium. And all other fruits can be taken, but the amount, portion size is very important. We can take 1 cup of fruits on a daily basis. If you want to take 1 apple, you can take 1 cup of papaya, 1 cup of chiku, 1 cup of strawberry, 1 cup of canberry, any fruits, but the portion size is 1 cup. Don't exceed the portion size, because as you increase the portion size, what happens? Because fruits contains potassium, it will accumulate in the body, it will make problem for you. So portion size, always remember, portion size is 1 cup. Now let's move to the cereals. In case of cereals, we advise all kidney failure patients to take wheat or rice. You can take wheat in any form. You can take wheat as a bread, as a cookie or any other form, but make sure you take only wheat or rice. Now let's move rice, and we have only 2 forms of rice which is available in India. One is poha and another is simple rice. You can take steamed rice, boiled rice, you can take poha, baited rice what we call it. So you can take any form of rice other than these two. I don't know the composition of other cereal like black gram or maize, so we don't advise such kind of things to our patients. So you can avoid all these cereals. Okay, this was the first part, how we can control the level of creatinine and potassium with the help of diet. Let's move how we can increase the function of kidney so that kidney can filter this creatinine, urea, potassium naturally. As we know, kidney has ability to increase its function, because when a person suffers from any kind of problem with a single kidney, what happens other than the kidney increases its size and starts functioning well. So if we use these functions of the kidney, if we use this property of kidney to increase its function, we can definitely increase the filtration of kidney and urea from the body. For that purpose, we have to use kidney function research and treatment, because in this treatment what we do is that we work on the cause of the kidney failure. As we know, the causes of the kidney failure are limited. It can be high blood pressure, it can be diabetes, it can be IgA nephropathy, it can be polycystic kidney. So we have to firstly identify the cause of kidney failure in your case specifically, so that we can work on the cause. Because if we want to increase the function of the kidney, if we want to slow down the progression of the disease, we have to stop the cause. We have to make control over the cause so that no further damage can be happened. So first thing is just to control the cause of kidney failure so that no further damage can be happened. In second step of kidney function research and treatment, what we do, we use the property of kidney to increase its function, and with the help of herbs, what happens, as the function of the kidney increases, kidney starts excreting out creatinine, urea, potassium and all other kind of electrolytes, waste material, acid in a large amount. And as this excretion happens, the level of all these material falls down in the body and the level of creatinine start dropping. So it's very important. Now when the body doesn't have any kind of cause that damages your kidney and body doesn't have extra amount of waste material, what happens, kidney starts healing itself. With the time, kidney make some kind of adjustment so that it can take a process of filtration on its basis. So it's very important for a kidney failure patient to understand what are the causes of kidney failure in their case, what kind of diet they should take, and how we can increase the function of the kidney. Because if you know all these things, you can easily manage your kidney failure disease. Now, if you have any kind of question, inquiry regarding kidney failure, you can simply call on the number given below. You can also book an appointment with me on the same number. You can also visit our website, Thank Kidney Care, for further information. With this, allow me to say good night. See you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.